parents of students with significant cognitive disabilities who are at the emergent level in their math skills need to have an understanding of how to create a home environment that supports the foundations of mathematics as their child moves toward beginning math skills. In this video, we'll discuss three key points to consider in order to help your child with the foundations of math while at home. Why is it important that my child is exposed to the foundations of math at home? How can I help with the foundations of math while my child is at home? What support can I ask for from my child's school? Why is it important that my child is exposed to the foundations of math at home? Math instruction in school helps children gain the skills and confidence to make sense of the world around them. In addition, opportunities to engage in math are plentiful at home. Examples include being able to set the table, make a budget for grocery shopping, and fill up the gas tank in your car. By engaging your child in opportunities like these to use their math skills in everyday activities, you can help your child generalize skills learned at school. Generalization is important because it ensures that a skill is available outside of the setting where the skill was learned. When what is learned generalizes and is used in other settings, then it has so much more usefulness in life. For math, if a child can identify a number on a flashcard, a clock, and in a recipe, it is likely the child has generalized learning. You have an opportunity to help your child develop foundational math skills without the use of worksheets and flashcards. You can do this simply through your everyday routines at home. How can I help with the foundations of math while my child is at home? There are five main foundational math skills that every child needs to learn. First is rote counting. This includes a child's ability to count out loud with numbers in order, or put a set of numbers in order.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Second, every child needs to learn to identify numbers. This begins with single-digit numbers like 1, 2, and 3. Then, identification advances to larger numbers with double and triple digits, such as 10 and 100. Anytime numbers are present in your environment, you can give your child a chance to see them in a new context. Third, children should learn to count with one-to-one correspondence. This means that they count in such a way that each object in a set is counted only once. If you are counting out forks for dinner, your child might count them one by one as they are taken out of the drawer and placed on the counter. Fourth, after one-to-one correspondence, children can begin to work on the next essential skill, which is making sets. When your child takes out 5 forks, for example, there is a set of 5. The fifth foundational math skill children need to learn is to compare quantities of objects. If you are playing a game like checkers, your child could identify which player has more checkers on the board. Rote counting, number identification, one-to-one correspondence, making sets, and comparing quantities may all seem like very separate skills, but they do overlap and can be supported at home together. What support can I ask for from my child's school? For additional resources about how to support emerging math skills at home, contact your child's teacher or instructional team. Ask about the approaches being used at school. Ask for ideas of how you and other family members can support emerging math skills while your child is at home. If your child's IEP does not have mathematics goals, or you want additional information, you may want to explore resources that are available online. For example, the modules addressing special education and teacher education, or MAST, have several modules focused on teaching mathematics, such as counting, cardinality, and number sense, and teaching mathematics to students with deafblindness and intellectual disabilities.